Hey guys, here player 123 again with this problem that is named this message will self-destruct in 5 seconds. So it basically says that we have N attendees in the party and they are giving attendee numbers from 1 through N. And the height of attendee I is AI. Now, according to what we have researched, a pair of attendees will come together to plan to steal the secret from Adcoder Kingdom only if the absolute difference of their attendee numbers is equal to the sum of their heads. Okay? In other words, a sum of the heads minus difference of the indexes is going to be equal to zero. In other words, so we have n times n minus 1 all divided by 2 ways to choose two attendees from the n attendees and make a pair, and we have to determine how many of these pairs satisfy the condition that we have just set. So for this problem we have an n that is going to be at most 2 times 10 to the power of 5, and the height of each attendee is going to be equal to 10 to the power of 9. We do have a problem here because we have just said that we have this number of ways to choose a pair from the n attendees, but we cannot actually see if we cannot actually select every possible pair and see if it satisfies the condition. We gotta optimize this a little bit. And this problem is interesting because of that, because you think that this is going to be an n square approach, but it turns out that you can simplify the problem, and we're gonna see how. So here we have one set of attendees heads. So we can see that we have just 3 possible pairs that satisfy this condition, that is 0 and 3. Okay, I know the problem says that we have to number them from 1 to n, but we are conveniently numbering them from 0 to n to n minus 1 because it doesn't matter to the solution of this problem. We are only counting the number of pairs, so we don't care about it. Okay, so the three pairs that satisfy the condition that we set are 0 and 3 because the sum of heads is equal to 2 plus 1, that is 3, and 3 minus 0, which is 3. 3 minus 3 equals 0, and that's it. Now, 3 plus 1 equals 4, and 5 minus 1 equals 4. 4 minus 4 equals 0, so the pair 1 and 5 is also possible. Now, 1 plus 1 equals 2, and 5 minus 3 equals 2, so then 2 minus 2 is equal 0, and we have discovered another pair. And there are no other pairs satisfying the condition. The answer to this problem is actually 3. So we're going to see how to compute this answer without actually taking all n square pairs that we have. So what we are going to do is that we are going to think of the possible results for trying to make a pair from the index 0 and another index. For example, pairing 0 and 1 will get us to the result of 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5, minus 1, which is equal 4. And pairing 0 and 2, you get 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5, minus 2, which is 3. So we can actually put those results in a table. As we said before, 2 plus 3 equals 5, minus 1 is equal 4. So we say that we have already one result that is equal to 4 when trying to make a pair from 0 and another index. We have to include 0, okay? Because we are looking for the solution only for the first index, okay? So When trying to make a pair from 0 and 2, you get 3, so we add this. Now, pairing 0 and 3 gets us to the result of 0, so we add 1 to 0. We said that we have one result of 0. Now, when pairing 0 and 4, you get 2 plus 3 equal 5 minus 4 equal 1, so you add this. And now 0 and 5, if you pair them, you get 2 plus 1, which is equal 3. 3 minus 5 is equal minus 2, so you get the one result of minus 2. Okay? In this problem, we should care about other results that are not 0. That's why we are counting them. We should care about them. We are gonna see why. We are not only caring for those that gives us the result of 0. We wanna make sure that we know all the other values, so these values can help us determine the answer for the next index. We're gonna see how. So at first, we only care about the result of 0. Okay, that's what matters for us. But we are not going to delete this, to erase this table. We are going to keep it as it is. We are only going to delete the result of pairing 0 and 1 when we make the transition from 0 to 1. So we are no longer pairing 0 with another index. We are now pairing 1 with another index. So what is the result of pairing 0 and 1? So we get 2 plus 3, which is 5, minus 1 equal 4. So you see, here we have one result of 4. Here we don't have it. So this is our updated table. How is this table going to give me the result for index 1? The answer of the number of pairings that I can make for index 1 and another index. Well, it turns out that we have to subtract 0 minus 1, which is equal minus 1, and subtract height of 0 and height of 1, which is 2 minus 3 equal minus 1. So you get minus 1 minus 1 equals minus 2. So we care about those results that were minus 2 in the table that we computed at value 0. And so when we were pairing 0 with another index, we got one pair. Now we get another pair, which is this one over here. You can actually prove that this is going to be true for all indexes. So now we move on to the index 2. So we gotta subtract the difference. So we gotta subtract the result of pairing 0 and 2, which is 2 plus 3 equals 5, minus 2 equals 3. So here we have 3. Here we have 3. And here we don't. Okay? So what is the result that I now care to compute the possible number of pairs for index 2? Which is minus 3. Why? Because we have 0 minus 2, which is equal minus 2, and 2 minus 3, which is equal minus 1. So minus 2 minus 1 is equal minus 3. And we don't even have minus 3 registers, so we add 0. So we get a result of 0 here. We have no pairing for 2 and another index. Now the same, we subtract the result of 0 and 3, which is 2 plus 1 equals 3 minus 3 equals 0. So here we have 0, and here we don't have 0. Okay? And now what is the result that I care about? It's minus 2, because 0 minus 3 is equal minus 3, and 2 minus 1 is equal 1, and minus 3 plus 1 equals minus 2. And we have one result of minus 2, so we add one possible pairing. And the same for index 4. We care about the result of 1. You can prove it at home. So there are no any ones anymore. So we add 0 here, and that's it. That is what we have to do to make this problem in something less than n squared. We're gonna see how to cut this solution. Okay, you guys, what is what we have to do here? So first read the value of n, because the problem says that we are given n. Then we're going to read the heads of every attendee, of every guest. And now we're going to count to compute the results for the first index as we saw in the solution. And we're going to store them in a map of long. This is actually long type. Long and long, okay? Now, we're going to have these variable n's as an accumulator of the possible pairings for a certain I. And this is the variable that is gonna tell us what result matters for us right now, okay? So at first, it matters for us the result of 0. Now, when I move to 1, I'm going to take out that result. So with the r0 plus r in position I, minus minus. So we say we don't have that result anymore. We can have more results of that type, but this result is not present anymore. So we compute the value of our variable current, that is going to be the difference of heads from the difference between the first head and the head in position I minus I, the value of I. And now we just have to accumulate this result in the variable that we have previously set, and that's it. We just have to print this variable, and that's it. We have already solved the problem. And I guarantee you that this is the correct solution, because this is the code that I submitted and I got accepted. And as you can see, we tried this for the first 32 digits of pi, and we get the result of 22, which is the one that we should get according to the test cases of AdCoder. So we get the result of 22, and that's it. So we're done with this problem. That's it for today, you guys. I hope this video was useful for you, that it was helpful. I hope you share it with those who need it. Remember, stay home programming, don't forget to subscribe, and see you in another video. Bye bye.